In a previous video, we saw how to set up a good development environment for Julia using VS Code and the VS Code extension for Julia. Now, VS Code is a great tool for programming, but if your main use case with Julia is data science, you should look into notebooks. A notebook is a document where you can mix standard text such as titles, paragraphs, equations, and also computer code. And the computer code helps you produce some parts of the document. And it's a good way to make your data science projects easy to set up and to reproduce. By using a same document for writing, programming, and computing and presenting all the outputs such as graphics, tables, or statistics, and analyze those outputs and communicate the results all in the same document. That's why notebooks are really popular for data exploration and communication, and there are well-known projects that helps you write notebooks. Probably the most well-known is Jupyter Notebooks, where you can write R or Python or Julia in the same notebook. There is also Rmarkdown that is really well-known, but today we will talk about Pluto.jl. Pluto is only compatible with Julia, but I think it has something more to offer compared to Rmarkdown or Jupyter Notebooks. The first benefit of Pluto is that notebooks are reactive. What the authors mean by reactive notebook is that the state of the document, meaning what you see in the notebook, always corresponds to the current code inside the document. So if you change some code in a part of the document, all the outputs that depend on this code are updated, and this is really important for reproducibility. So let's find out how that's working by installing Pluto.jl on your computer. The first step is to add Pluto.jl to your Julia environment, and to do so, we have to open Julia and enter the package manager mode by pressing the closing bracket on your keyboard like this. The closing bracket is this one. Now simply type add Pluto.jl and press enter. So what it did here is download the package and all the dependencies. So now we want to use the package. So we have to press backspace to quit the package manager mode. And now we can use the package by typing using Pluto enter. And the first time it will recompile Pluto, so it can take a little bit. So when you type using Pluto, it tells you how to run Pluto here. So we'll follow the instruction. You just have to type pluto.run. And it opened the Pluto.js session in my web browser. And now we can navigate to our own notebooks, create a new notebook, or use a sample notebook they provide here. And if you have some time, you can look at the sample notebooks because they explain everything you have to know about Pluto.jl in 6 examples. But for this video, we will start from a new file. So here we just have to click on new notebook and it will open a fresh notebook. And now we can write any Julia code, for example, a equals 1, and evaluate it using shift enter, and the output is returned just above the cell here. Now we can add a second cell, for example, by pressing Ctrl Enter, B equals 2, for example. And if I press Ctrl Enter now, it will execute the code and create a new cell. Now I can add a computation, for example, A plus B. And if I press Shift Enter, it will return the result here. And the interesting thing about Pluto.jl is it's reactive, as I said earlier. So if I change the value of A here and I change it to be 5, for example, and I re-execute just this cell with A equals 5, it will modify the third cell where we have the computation A plus B. Why? Because it's the principle of a reactive notebook. If you change a cell, all the other cells that depends on the result of this cell will be updated for you. We can also add some text now. So to add some text, I have to create a new cell. So if I want my text just before this cell, I will click on the plus, create a new cell. And all text is written in Markdown inside Pluto.jl. So we have to tell Julia that it's a Markdown cell by using the MD command and then wrap all text inside quotes. So here I would write, this is my text, for example, and use Shift Enter to add the text. And so now this is not really beautiful because we have the output here and the Markdown here, but we can make this invisible by clicking here. So we have just the text appearing. And we can also add a title here using the same process. And to make a title, because it's in Markdown, we have to use this command. So Shift Enter, and we don't want the Markdown to appear here. So we have a title, a paragraph, and some Julia instructions. We can also mix Julia code and Markdown inside the same cell. For example, here I can create a Markdown cell that says A plus B. So here it's just Markdown. So if I execute this, it's writing A plus B. And if I want to execute A plus B, I can say A plus B equals, and here I want the result to appear, so we want to execute some code. Well, we can use the dollar function here, and it will execute everything that is inside the parentheses. So I can write A plus B here, and it will be interpreted as Julia code. So if I execute it, it will return A plus B equals 7, because here A plus B was executed as Julia code. We can also make plots inside Pluto.jl. So if I want to use the plots package, I would write this using plots, wait for the execution, then add a new cell and use the plot function like in any other developing environment for Julia, and press shift enter. And now the plot is printed just above the cell here. So we can also remove here using plots. So one of the downsides of using Pluto is that you can't declare a variable and or change its state in different places. So for example, if I create a new variable called A again, but this time it will be equal to 10. Well, Pluto has no way of knowing if A equals 10 or A equals 5. So it will return an error here. Now it can be viewed as a downside, but it rather is a feature of Pluto.jl because it helps you make cleaner and more reproducible code. How? Well, the state of your variables does not depend on the way you execute the code inside your notebook. For example, if you execute a cell before or after the other, it will not have any consequence inside a Pluto notebook, but it will have rather important consequences inside Jupyter notebooks or Rmarkdown. And this is very important to avoid any errors due to execution timeline. Another little downside of using Pluto.jl is if you want to write several lines of code inside a single cell, well, you have to wrap them inside a begin and statement. So if I want to write, for example, D equals 10 and then A plus D, well, it wouldn't work. Multiple expressions in one cell, how would you like to fix it? Well, we have two solutions now. Split this cell into two cells. So if I click here, it will make two different cells, one for each command. Or wrap all code in a begin end block. So if I click here, it will wrap my code, D equals 10, A plus D, inside a begin end statement, and then it works. Another very interesting thing about Pluto notebooks is that the document produced is just a Julia script. So you can run the code even if you don't have Pluto.jl installed on your computer. And because it's just text, well, you can also use versioning. And we will make several videos about versioning because it plays a really important role in Julia programming and also in research and data science in general. And that Pluto notebooks just being regular scripts, in my opinion, is a really big argument in favor of Pluto. And the last thing I wanted to show you is that when you're done with your notebook, you can save it on different formats. At the moment, there are three different formats that are provided by Pluto.jl. Either a notebook file, so it's the Julia file I showed you earlier, or a static HTML file, or a static PDF. And so for example, if I click on static HTML, I can save it on my disk and then share the HTML file like any other file, or just opening it in Firefox like any other web page. I won't go in much more details about Pluto.jl, mainly because there are two wonderful videos made by the creators themselves of Pluto.jl, and you'll find the link in the description of this video. I highly encourage you to watch them because they are really wonderful and they go much more deeper into the details of the package. Thank you for watching, and if you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments. This video is part of a playlist, so if you're interested in Julia development, you can watch all the videos I make in order from that playlist. Thank you for watching, and I see you next time.